Hi, my name is Yuki Shigemoto from the Texas Sex Psychology Department. I'm here to talk about grad school preparation and applications. Graduate school application takes a lot of time, so if you're thinking of applying to graduate school, start immediately. And start looking into and considering the general requirements as soon as you can. Some school lists the minimum GRE, GPA, so checking those scores will give you roughly the scores you need to apply to those schools. And keep in mind that competitive graduate schools require competitive applications. So look at requirements early, for example, like sophomore year, and plan accordingly. And try to maintain grades throughout your college career. And again, don't waste your time, and don't wait till last minute to apply or looking into general requirements. And GPA, usually for applying to competitive schools, you need to maintain at least 3.5 or higher. And even applying to lower competitive schools, you need to have at least a GPA of 3.0 or higher. The higher GPA, the better chances you have, so try to keep your GPA as high as possible. And one of the scores that most of the graduate school requires is a GRE. And GRE consists of three sections: verbal, math, analytic, writing section. And try to check the ETS website, ETS Educational Testing Services website, to kind of like gather the up-to-date information as they keep on changing. So try to get the latest information. And some of the schools require the psychology subject test, so check the school website that you're trying to apply, and make sure if they are requiring or not. And plan to take the GRE well in advance, and no later than October of the year you plan to apply. And try to use study aids. There's a lot of books for the GRE guidebooks, tabling courses, books, vocab, cars, online resources. So those are the things that it will aid you in studying.
Hi, my name is Nathaniel Taylor, and I'm from the Texas Tech Psychology Department Advising Office. I'm going to be talking about some additional requirements for applying to graduate school. Research experience is a very important component of your application to graduate school. It's important that as an undergraduate you begin to gain some research, as research is often a critical component of graduate school. It's one of the ways that at Texas Tech that you can apply for research is by finding a professor that matches your research interests within the psychology department. This is called the Individual Problems Course, or PSY 4000. And probably the best way to approach this is to go on the Texas Tech Psychology website and find a professor who matches your research interest, then email them to ascertain whether there are open RA positions at this time. Another important component of your graduate school application are letters of recommendation. Oftentimes it's important to generate around 3 letters of recommendation for your graduate school application, and this can be accomplished by establishing good relationships with your psychology professors and other faculty members who know you well. Then they can comment on your academic abilities and other qualities that would make you a good candidate for a graduate school program. It's important to remember that letters of recommendation often take some time to right by the faculty members, so it's important to let them know early that you would like to have a letter of recommendation sent on your behalf. Another good way to generate a letter of recommendation is to work as a research assistant within a lab. This will provide the professor that you're working with ample experience on your academic abilities to be able to comment in a letter of recommendation. A personal statement is a formal written statement of purpose for why you would like to attend graduate school and some of your strengths that will make you a good candidate within a graduate program. It's important to take a good deal of time to consider what you would like to include within your statement of purpose, as this is a very personal essay that tells the graduate school committees why you deserve to be in their programs. A good way to do this is to plan an outline, then revise, edit, and proofread, and ask for much feedback from a number of different people on your personal statement. Typical themes that are encompassed within a personal statement are your long-term career plans, your areas of interest, specifically your research interest and clinical interest within psychology, and then your reasons for applying to a specific university. Essays should be original for every program, so it is good to take some time to plan an individual essay for each program you're applying to. Finally, word limits should be restricted to around 500 to 1,000 words, but it's important to follow the specific guidelines provided by the programs. A curriculum vitae is often included in your graduate school application as well. A curriculum vitae is a formal resume or academic resume that encompasses all the work that you've done up to this point within an academic setting. It will include your education, research experiences, clinical experiences, honors and awards, and other important highlights of your academic career that you would like to make known. This document is often important to kind of fill in the gaps within your application and show some additional aspects of your professional development to this point. Once you have applied to a college or university for graduate school, the next step is an interview process. If you are viewed as a strong candidate for a particular program, you may be invited to interview formally for a specific lab or with a specific group within that program. It's important to know ahead of time the specific research of the lab or the professor that you'll be working with so that you can discuss how your research interests match up with theirs and how your work up to this point has matched with their interest as well. In-person interviews are ideal, but oftentimes phone interviews is offered as well. I would strongly recommend going to in-person interviews if you can.